the reading of our text for today. We thank you, God, for the presence of your people. And we pray for those that are not here, that they will find themselves worshiping you in spirit and in truth. I pray, Lord, that you will continue to comfort us in the midst of the things that we are experiencing in life, to continually reassure us, O God, even though we already know it, but in the flesh, we need a lot of reassuring that you will never leave us nor forsake us, and that your faithfulness will never wane, O God. I pray that you will help each and every one of us, Lord, find your perfect will in our lives, and that our whole life, Lord, will be consumed in doing your will for us. I pray, Lord, that you will give us enough grace that no matter what we experience, O God, we will always see your hand, we will always see your purpose, and we will always see, O God, why you are allowing things to happen in our lives. I pray, Lord, that you will bless me as I preach your word today. Give me wisdom, O God, that's coming from you. Because there is no wisdom resting within me, O God, that can explain your word, and that myself could be a blessing to your people, except with the help of the Holy Spirit. So I pray, Lord, that you will speak to us, and whatever else will be lacking, Lord, I pray that you will supply it, so that after we hear your word, we will not only be fed with your word, but we will rejoice, and we will apply them, O God, with the help of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Thank you, O God. Forgive us of our sins. Make us worthy today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. You may be seated. Thank you very much. So tomorrow, Brother Claude, Sister Shine, and Sister Jonah, they will be traveling to Phnom Penh. We might go. Actually, we will go with them, and they will wait for their flight on the 11th, going back to the Philippines. It might be for good, or it may not be, but it's going to take, I believe, a long time, if ever that the Lord will open doors for them again to come here. But what's important is that no matter where they will be, that they will find themselves doing the will of God, worshiping God continually in spirit and in truth, and being used for the glory of God. It may not be much of a problem for Brother Claude and Sister Jean, because they will be going back to the church of their father. Their father is their pastor in the Philippines. In the case of Sister Jonah, let's pray that the Lord will guide her to a church that will continually feed her with the truth from the Word of God, so that she will continue to grow and be of use for God's glory in the Philippines. And Lord willing, if our paths will someday cross again, I pray that we will continue to be a blessing to each other. Amen. So we have read our text, Nehemiah chapter 8. And if you remember, Brother Jong preached a whole sermon regarding Nehemiah chapter 8. And when he preached this sermon, he talks about the feast that they neglected to do for a long, long time. And he talked about the timing of this chapter, and some other technical details that is actually being done in a careful Bible study of Nehemiah chapter 8. So I'm not going to do it again, because you have heard it. We have heard how he open these things up to us, but I'm just going to speak in the aspect of how we must listen to a message. How we must listen to a message. Because you see, as a Christian, listening to a message, a sermon, or a preaching is common in our Christian life. If we will count it, maybe we have heard thousands of sermons while sitting on the pews, looking up to the pulpit and listening to sermon being preached by a preacher, your pastor, and some other proclaimers of the Word of God. We can say that if we are going to be mindful of what we are listening to, then we might have heard almost on almost every topic that can be discussed in the Word of God. But if we will look at ourselves and how we are conducting or living our lives, we can see that we are still falling way short of God's standard and God's will for our lives. And the reason for that is because maybe we do not listen well. Maybe we do not really understand what is being preached, or maybe we just don't care about what is being preached. You see, we need to take heed that we hear. Whenever we are in the church, we need to take heed what we hear to understand it, and we need to take heed how we hear. It should be with anticipation, reverence, and excitement, because this is the Word of God. We are hearing the most important voice in our life, and that is God's Word. And mind you that the Bible puts a premium on hearing when Romans 10:17 says, by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. So it is very important that we know how to listen, that we know how to hear the Word of God. You know, I know that it is my duty every time I stand behind this pulpit to preach to you. And it is your duty to listen to me. And I can only hope and pray that you don't finish before I do. Because I will be wasting my time. We will be wasting the Word of God. And we are not going to profit from the Word of God. Let us end at the same time. Amen? As I preach and you listen to the Word of God. You see, listening to God's Word, as I have discussed this morning, is very beneficial to each and every one of us. There is no success without the Word of God, Joshua 1:8. We will not know where to go without the Word of God, Psalms 119. We cannot be cleansed without the Word of God, Psalms 19. The Word of God is magnified by the Lord Jesus, or by God, more than all His name. It is purified 7 times. The Word of God is pure. The Word of God is so important that we need to be careful on how we listen to the Word of God. Look at Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 2. It says here, for unto us was the gospel preached, or the message, or the sermon, or whatever it is, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. It is very much possible to sit listening to thousands and thousands of preaching, and yet it will not even affect our lives in a positive way, in a spiritual way. Why? Because if we will not take heed and listen carefully to the Word of God, it's not going to profit us. You see, I do not know what is the English of gabi. Yung gabi, yung taro. You know the leaves of the taro? Even if it will rain the whole night, you just shake it, it's still dry. It does not retain the rainwater, even though it rained overnight. Like the duck may go underwater when it emerged and do some shaking. It is again dry. Have you seen a person with a curly hair swimming? When he goes out of the water, the hair is dry, the kinky hair. It's not retaining the water. And sad to say, many Christians are like that. No matter how many sermons they listen to, the result is the same. And that is constantly nothing. There is a joke about this thing that there were three, a doctor, a lawyer, and a Baptist preacher went on a hunting trip. And then they saw a deer. I think the highest pointer is it 10 or 12? I'm not sure. But hunter knows that. And it is a prize deer if you will be able to kill it and have it for a trophy. All of them put their sight on the deer. All of them fired at the same time. And only one of them hit the deer. And then the lawyer said, I'm sure. I know legally that I am the one who hit the deer. I'm the one who felled that deer. And then the Baptist preacher protested, I believe I am the one. But the doctor, being objective, examined the deer. He looked at the deer. He looked at the wound. He looked at all the possible medical explanation that he could get, and he came out with a solution, and he said, I am pretty sure the Baptist preacher hit the deer. The lawyer protested, how can you be sure? Because the bullet hit the deer went from one ear and exited the other ear. And that is what is happening almost every Sunday when a preacher is shooting us with the Word of God. Amen? I hope and I pray that's not going to happen to us. Amen? Looking at Nehemiah chapter 8, what are the things that we can see? How these people listen to the Word of God? Number one, they listen anticipatively. They listen anticipatively. Look at verse number 1. Verse number 1, please. And all the people gathered themselves together as one man in the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Ezra the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel. So when the people called for the book of the law of Moses, they were expecting to hear what God had to say to them. Amen. That should be our attitude whenever we come here and sit down. We must anticipate that we are going to hear and we will listen to the Word of God. Because if you are not going to anticipate, it shows that there is no hunger for the Word of God. There is no thirst for the Word of God. There is no interest for the Word of God. And without a goal when coming to church, you are sure to hit that goal. So there must be anticipation that what we're going to hear is the Word of God. And if we know that what we will hear is the Word of God, then there will be great anticipation in our heart. You will see they were as one man, they're listening as one man. You can see that they are quiet and they are anticipating every word that will be read out of the book of the law. That is why it is very important to listen. It is very important to anticipate that we are going to hear the Word of God whenever we come to the place where we worship the Lord. So how can we have this anticipation to listen to the Word of God? Number one, we must appreciate the Word of God. Because if they do not appreciate the word of God, there will be no anticipation to hear the word of God. You see, when there is a person that you appreciate in life, when there is a person that you look up to, and that person will come and that person will speak, then you will listen with much anticipation to that person. Amen? And who can be more important than God in our lives? So that is why there must be anticipation when we listen to the word of God. And every Sunday or every time our church is open for the word of God, then there must be a fresh appreciation for the word of God. Why do we need to appreciate the word of God? Because the word of God is everything to us. Without the word, we cannot survive. This word, the Bible says, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. How can we be able to stand against temptation? By the word of God. The Lord Jesus Christ was tempted 3 times, and twice he used the word of God, and by the grace of God, he became successful in warding off that temptation. And ladies and gentlemen, without being saturated by the word of God, we are going to be an easy prey for the devil. He can easily destroy us and make us fall into temptation. That is why our attitude for the word of God is we should give the Bible unlimited hearing. Unlimited hearing. Whenever there is a chance to listen to the word of God, then we must make ourselves available and anticipate that we are going to hear more from God. You see, sometimes when the preaching is becoming long, we lose our desire. We lose our enthusiasm in listening to the word of God. But it is not true to the things that we enjoy in life. Are we showing that we do not enjoy the word of God? Are we saying that the word of God is not important in our lives? If the word of God is important, then it doesn't matter how long it may be. We must always be ready and anticipate to hear the word of God. Amen? Our hearing of God's word must not be occasional or irregular. It must be regular, and every time we have a chance, we need to hear the word of God. Not only unlimited hearing, but unhindered hearing. When we listen to the sermon or when we listen to the word of God, and because we have appreciation to the word of God, then we must love the work, the word of God, and to seek to hear it every chance we have. And let us see to it that there will be no distraction as we listen to the word of God. That's why we see to it, we instruct our members, if your baby will cry, we have a nursery, you can bring them out for a while. Why? Because we want to listen to the word of God without any distraction. Because we deem that it is important. We believe it is important. But not only that. You may be sitting quietly, but if your mind is wandering, then that's the same thing. You are being hindered in hearing the word of God. That's why even if you have a problem or whatever your care may be, you leave it out of that door, you come in here, and you anticipate that God will speak to you and God will give the solution to every problem that we may have. Because that is the purpose of the word of God. To strengthen us, to help us, to guide us. And our God is a help in times of trouble. That's why we need to listen to the word of God without being hindered. That is very important. That's why when you come here, you pray, Lord, help me to listen anticipatively to the preaching of your word, so that if that will happen, you can say, answered prayer. Amen? That you have learned things from the word of God as you listen to his word. Number two, we must listen attentively. Look at verse number 3. And he read therein before the street, that was before the water gate from morning until midday. Amen? Morning until midday. Before the men and the women and those that could understand and the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law. So they listen attentively. It doesn't matter how long, from morning to midday, they listen attentively to the word of God. You see, our attention span most of the times are very limited, especially when it comes to the word of God. But when you watch Ang Provinciano, a soap opera in the Philippines that's been on for almost 10 years. How many years? 4 years. And still nothing is happening in that soap opera. And yet, 80% of the Filipino people are attentive to that soap opera, where all they do for 1 hour is look at each other. For 1 hour. And yet, your attention span goes beyond that. Ladies and gentlemen, when you listen to the word of God, you concentrate. It means there is a deliberate effort in listening to the word of God. You see, most of the time when the preaching is going on, most of the time when you're reading the Bible, then the evil spirits, the demons, will come and will try to take our attention that we may not profit from the word of God. Sabi nga sa Tagalog, in our vernacular, kapag ka meron ng preaching, yung mga dumunyito naglalambitin sa talukap ng iyong mga mata, pilit na hinihila para ikaw ay mapapikit at mali yung attention mo. Pitikin mo! Nang sa ganun, makapag-concentrate ka sa pakikinig sa salita ng Diyos. Amen? Do everything. Sometimes you might feel sleepy. I think some are experiencing it right now. Do something about it. Pastor, are you always attentive when you listen? I hope I can do it consistently, but I must confess, there are times that I feel sleepy when listening to a sermon. So I do something to help myself be awake until the end of the sermon and understand most of what being preached. I already told you that. I sit at the edge of the chair so that I will be conscious that if I will fall asleep, then I will fall to the floor and will be, what do you call that? And I'm going to be a laughing stock of the church because of that. So because of that effort and consciousness, I am being helped to become awake and listen attentively until the end of the preaching. You see, God made us with two ears that we cannot close unless you stop it. And one mouth that we can close. So during the preaching, open your ears, listen, and shut your mouth. Amen? You see, in the church, there's only one pulpit. Only one is doing the preaching. But sometimes, almost everybody is preaching in their seat. And we are not concentrating in listening to the word of God. If your intention is to preach, bring your own pulpit. At least we know what is your intention in coming to the church. Amen? So there must be effort. There must be concentration. And let us do everything to guarantee ourselves that whenever we are in a church, then we are going to listen attentively to the word of God. How can you do that? Prepare to hear. Prepare yourself. I will go to the church and I'm going to listen to the word of God. I'm going to be conscious and that is what I'm going to do. Look at James 1:21. Wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness and receive with meekness the engrafted word which is able to save your souls. James liken our hearts into a garden and the word of stay there please. And the phrase superfluity of naughtiness, it means that it is a garden, so it is something that is not tilled, something that is not controlled, and therefore it's not going to yield anything. So that is what James is saying. He is urging us to pull out the weeds and prepare the soil for the seed of the word of God. Because we're not going to do anything, then the seed will fall into a ground that is not fruitful and it will be wasted. That is why it is very important that we look at our heart and see to it that our heart is ready to listen to the word of God. And then I mentioned it a while ago, not only prepare to hear, but pray to hear. Pray to God, Lord, help me to listen to the word of God. Help me to forget of all the distractions that may happen. Help me to forget about my cares and my worries, whatever problems I may have. Help me, O God, to concentrate and listen to your word, because I know when I listen to your word, then I will benefit spiritually from whatever is going to be preached in the church. Amen? Number three, listen actively. Listen actively. We need not to be passive in our hearing. Look at verse number 6. And Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, Amen, Amen. So, they are active in listening. It is like interactive. They are responding to the preaching of God's word. Listen, it is not a guarantee that when you amen to the preaching, it doesn't mean you're spiritual. It only means that you are awake. And you are attentively listening to the word of God. Because if not, you may not be able to say amen, or you may say amen in wrong places. I remember when I was pastoring in the Philippines, Brother Eric is always sleeping in the church. And I signaled to the one sitting beside him to nudge him. And when he was nudged, you know Brother Eric, sister, was he your classmate before? Or just schoolmate? Schoolmate. Because Teacher Lily was my student before and also Brother Eric, member of our church. So he was nudged and I said, who wants to go to hell? Say amen! And when he was nudged, he said, amen! And all the people are looking at him. Because he wants to go to hell. Why? Because you're not listening attentively and you are pretending to be active when you do not really know what's happening because you were sleeping during the preaching. You see, actively listening means you are listening to every word, taking notes, responding, nodding your head, smiling, whatever, showing that you are interested in what is going on in the preaching. And by doing that, you are helping yourself to listen carefully. Again, it doesn't mean that because you say amen, you are spiritual. Because some people will keep on saying amen, sometimes disturbing other people in listening to the word of God. You sense amen when saying amen. But active listening is something that is very important. You can see that, when wives talk to their husband, there is only one thing that they desire, that the husband is really listening to them. Because it is exasperating when you're talking to your husband and then the mind of your husband is in basketball. Kobe Bryant wondering if he's in heaven or hell. Or thinking about LeBron James. Or thinking about the Lakers. Or thinking about baseball. Or thinking about the weather. Or thinking about fishing. You will see if people are not interested, if people are not listening to you, they may be looking, but you can see it in their eyes. You can see it in their their body language. Usually when you're talking to a person, usually when that person is very interested, they usually lean forward. But of course, sometimes they might be in a normal position because they might get tired of leaning forward. But you will see that there is the interaction. They nod their heads, something like that. And then you know that they're interested and you are going to be excited and you're going to engage them longer in a conversation. I remember I was in Houma, in Louisiana, and they use Cajun English over there. And sometimes Americans cannot understand Cajun English because it is a French way of speaking in English. And I was in Patterson, there in near Houma, and after the preaching, the pastor invited me to their home to eat dinner. And we're talking, and they're talking, and then all of a sudden, they laugh, and I laugh. And then he said, "Brother Joe, yes, sir, I'm asking you a question." "Oh, is that so? What's your question, sir?" So they know that I'm not listening. I may be active, but I'm not listening. And some of you sometimes are like that.
What will be the VM? What will I do tonight?
You see, you can fool me, but you cannot fool God. Amen. I remember this member who wore a sunglass inside the church. And then while the preaching is going on, he's getting sleepy. And he said, the pastor said, "Oh, he is agreeing to the message." And then the pastor got excited and really preached the word of God. And then all of a sudden, he said, "Oh, he is now disagreeing with my message." So the pastor looked for a way to, you know, change some of what he's saying. And then he said, "It's now undecided because it's now going around the world." And then all of a sudden the head fell and he was fast asleep. So be active, but at the same time, you need to be listening to the word of God. Amen? Say amen, smile, do things as much as possible, do not yawn. It is very discouraging to a preacher to see members yawning while the preacher is preaching. And I do not understand, some members will even not only just yawn, but while the preaching is going on. Have some decency. Amen. I told our members when I was pastoring in the Philippines, if you cannot help but yawn, at least cover your mouth and yawn like this. See, if there is a tear, then I know what happened. So there must be active participation when we are listening to the word of God. Amen? Because it is insulting to God if his children are not listening to his word. Amen? Number four, we must listen affectionately. Listen affectionately. Look at verse number 12. Verse number 12. And all the people went their way to eat and to drink and to send portions and to make great meals because they had understood the words that were declared unto them. Look at verse number 8. So they read in the book, in the law of God distinctly and gave sense and caused them to understand the reading. So in verse 8, the leaders helped them to understand the word of God. in verse 12, they became glad and happy because they understand the word of God and they were able to obey God's word. If we understand the word of God and we obey the word of God, then our love for God will grow stronger. Amen. He will become sweeter to us. He will become more precious to us. We are going to be closer to God as we know Him more and more, as we listen to the Word of God. You see, when we search the Scripture, we will know about Jesus. When study the Bible, we will know about Jesus. We will see how He suffered and how He died, and how He is now sitting at the right hand of the Father and being our advocate, so that no matter what happens, our salvation is secured by the grace of God. And if we will understand everything that God has done, is doing, and will do for us, then we are going to love Him more and more in our lives. Amen? You see, don't you see that sometimes as you know the person more and more, then you love him more, or you will hate him more? But the point is that when they were caused to understand the word of God, they love him more. That is the reason why in verse 3, they're not even wearied, even though 5 or 6 hours of listening that they have done during that day outside from morning till midday, maybe under the heat of the sun, it doesn't matter. Because if you love something, or if you love God, then you are going to have that, not patience, but excitement to listen and to be a part of what is happening under any circumstance. Amen? I remember that we need to be reminded that there are many churches in China and Vietnam who are having underground church. It is not comfortable, but they don't care. They love the word of God. They love God. So even at the risk of their lives, they're going to worship the Lord and listen to the word of God. I remember reading the book, Martyrs of the Catacomb. It is a very hard place to go, to gather and to worship God. But they do it anyway. But they did it anyway. Why? Because they love God. They love the word of God. You see, if there is that love for God, as we know Him and understand Him, then there is nothing that can stop us in listening to the word of God with love in our hearts. You know, I enjoy listening to Sister Maribel. Do you know why? Because there is affection that is happening between the two of us. And that is the same thing with the people that we love. We will enjoy listening to them. And if we love God, there is what we call affection, or we will listen to the word of God affectionately because we love the Lord. Look at Proverbs 1:5. Proverbs chapter 1 and verse number 5. A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. So it will increase your learning. You're gaining wisdom. You're knowing God more. And then your affection to the word of God is becoming greater and greater. It will result in Psalms 119, verse 97. Psalms 119, verse 97. The Bible, 119, 97. Oh, how love I thy law. It is my meditation all the day. You see, when you love the word of God, you want to be in the word of God the whole day. As much as when you love a person, you want to be with that person the whole day. So the same thing. That's why when we listen affectionately, we are going to enjoy the word of God. Amen? There are two people are listening to the same preaching. One says, it is long. And the other says, it seems to be long. But listen, if you love the word of God, it may be long, but it seems that it's not even long. Amen? You try to spend time with the person that you love, you will not even know that time is passing you by. And you do not even care about what time is it. Because you enjoy being with the person. And if we love the Word of God, we don't care about time. What we care is that we know, we listen, and we enjoy and we delight in the Word of God. That's why sometimes, even in almost all pulpit, it is being mentioned that we enjoy sitting in a ball game or watching a ball game for many, many hours and remain excited about it, especially when our team is winning. Sometimes we jump, we clap, we shout, we run, we do show all kinds of emotion, especially when it is a championship game. I remember watching Los Angeles Lakers defeating Boston Celtics. I remember jumping around because they won. And I watched for many hours that game. But I wonder, can I do the same thing listening to the Word of God? Will I be as equally and should be much more excited listening to the Word of God? Because if you love God's Word, if you are really saved and you love God and the Word of God, there will be rejoicing when you listen and when you hear the Word of God. So that's why we must listen affectionately. Number five. We must listen appropriately. Appropriately. Look at verse number 16. So the people went forth and brought them and made themselves booths, everyone upon the roof of his house, and in their courts, and in their courts of the house of God, and in the street of the water gate, and in the street of the gate of Ephraim. Why did they do this? Because they found out from the Word of God it is something that they need to do, which they have not done for a long, long time, or have never done in their lives, because they do not know the Word of God. So when the Word of God revealed this to them, they obeyed the Word of God. And listen to me, the only appropriate way of listening to the Word of God is to apply the Word of God in our lives. Anything short of that is not appropriate. Because that is the purpose. When we hear the Word of God, look at James 1:25. James 1:25. But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. So we listen so that we can know, and then we apply the Word of God in our lives. So how do we respond to the Word of God? Do we heed the Word of God? Do we obey the Word of God? Do we listen to the Word of God with a desire that no matter what we hear, we are going to apply it in our lives? Even though if we are rebuked by the Word of God, we will humbly accept it. If we are instructed, we are going to accept it and do it in our lives. If we are being reproved by the Word of God, are we humble enough to just submit ourselves to the Word of God? Why? Because the Word of God is our final authority in faith, practice, in our lives. If we are not under the authority of the Word of God, then we are setting up our lives for a fall. That is why we need to know how to listen to the Word of God. Because there is always the possibility of wasting our time when we come to the church, when we gather as a church. There is always the possibility of hearing without understanding. There is always the possibility that the Word of God preached to us may be stolen by the devil, and therefore it will not profit us. So we must listen carefully to the Word of God with anticipation. And then as we go through, we must listen appropriately. And the only appropriate response, I will repeat and end with this, to listening to the Word of God is to apply God's Word in our lives. I hope and I pray that we will respect the Word of God, we will love the Word of God, and we will allow the Word of God to permeate our lives. So it is our duty and responsibility, listen, to saturate ourselves with the Word of God. Shall we stand up, please? Every head's bowed. Thank God for today that we were able to listen once again to His Word. And as we listen, I hope that we're going to listen to the Word of God with anticipation. That we will listen to the Word of God with much attention. That there is proper corresponding action as we listen to the Word of God. That our affection must be in God's Word. And then we must listen, appropriating God's Word in our lives. I believe that if these things will be done in our lives, then the Word of God will profit us. Because as we listen mixed with faith to God's Word. John will play a hymn of invitation. And if the Lord has spoken to your heart regarding the preaching today, then let us ask God to help us.